Hey, welcome to Friday Night Lights. I'm Craig Smiley. He's Mike Fenner. And Mike, the high school football season is officially a wrap. We're on to winter sports and one of those high school hoops.
And tonight, not only two of Pennsylvania's best, but two of the nation's best boys basketball players squaring off just a short drive away. The 2-1 McDowell Trojans head to Butler to face the 3-0 Golden Tornadoes.
And for the Trojans, 6'7 sophomore William Jeffress Jr. For Butler, 6'5 junior guard Ethan Morton with offers from everywhere. Pitt's Jeff Capel, Michigan's John Beilein in the house. Early on, Morton gets the jumper. He led everybody with 32. For McDowell, they led 13-5 after one, thanks to plays like this. Jeffress, the steal and the slam. Kid knows how to elevate. 23 points, 16 boards. Trojans trailing the fourth. But here comes Jack Gallagher, 2 of his 10. McDowell down 73-69, less than 20 seconds to go. Johann Sebastian Bach from the corner makes it a one-point game. Butler making their free throws, and McDowell down 3. Last chance, Gallagher for the tie. Butler beats the Trojans in a close one. Your final, 75-72.
How about the Lewis Fitness and Performance scoreboard? We go Cathedral Prep losing tonight, 71-56 at North Allegheny. Liam Gallo with 19 points. Michael Lucarotti with 18 for Prep. The Ramblers will host Fairview December 28th. And more from Region 7. Meadville beats Grove City in a tight one, 57-57. 27 points for LaShawn Lindsay to lead the Bulldogs. Kennedy Catholic wins its first game of the season, 75-62 over Aspire Academy out of Kentucky. Maseo Austin and Oscar Tashibi.
Shubwe
with Maceo 24
Austin
points.
Austin and Oscar Shubwe with 24 apiece for Canada. We'll try harder next time. Back in town, 8 of the 9 teams in Region 4 are matched up tonight, including 2 schools that are just 6 miles apart. You know these ones.
Girard has lost 5 straight meetings with rival Fairview, and the Yellow Jackets' last win over the Tigers came in 2008. But let's be fair, these two teams didn't play each other for 8 seasons after that
Where
last
were you
Girard
in 2008?
Victory. Just getting ready to start high school, I think. 2 of the best around. How about Pat Flaherty and Girard's Darren Mays getting at it tonight? 7-point game for the Tigers with the lead in the fourth. Matt Nyland adding to it. 9-point lead. 8 points for him. Girard not going away quietly, though. Cam Feathers sweeping down the lane. 2 of his team high. 13 for the Yellow Jackets. And then it's Feathers out of the corner this time. The baseline drive, the finish, and the foul cuts it to a 4-point game on the and one. In less than 2 minutes to play, Girard still sticking with it. Corey Dinger, 2 of his 8. It's a 32-30 game, 156 to play, but that's as close as Girard would get. The Fairview defense comes up big, and the free throw shooting was even better. 8 down the stretch, Fairview takes it 40-32, despite just 1 field goal in the final frame.
We're not making shots. Sometimes it's a tough situation for us. So, Girard did a great job defending us. They play really hard, and I'm proud of our guys, though. I thought we kept doing what we want to try to do, and we found a way to win.
They came in within 2 points with, 2 minutes left, and then we just had to keep battling, taking it one possession at a time, and getting stops and trusting our defense.
Make it 6 straight wins for Fairview over Girard as we head back to the Lewis Fitness and Performance scoreboard. 9 points for Nick Sundberg, 8 for Matt Nyland. For Fairview, the Tigers win it in this one, 40-32. Staying in Region 4, plenty of time for Conneaut, Ohio to get the hair right tonight, visiting Will Gadsden's Northwestern Wildcats after a marathon JV game. It's Northwestern senior guard Jonah Hawley working it through the lane for a pair. Cats take the early lead. Next trip down, Robbie Everhart finding Hawley, who just didn't realize he was this wide open. Then he knocks down the 3, 5-0 lead for the Wildcats. Spartans trailing by 10 in the blink of an eye, but a 3-ball here helps the cause. Actually, a long 2 for junior Richie Picard. He had 14 for the Spartans, but Northwestern 2 much. Everhart the steal, going coast to coast, 18 points. Jeremy Dohanik with 21. The Wildcats and the Spartans, their first loss of the season, 56-52.
Out to Wattsburg we go. Mercy, here's Prep visiting Seneca Bobcat Country. Lakers get it started. Griffin Heron from the wing finds Nick Byerly, who gets to the tin for 2 of his 4 points. And here come the Bobcats at the other end, moving it well. Matt Zajac down low for Zach Cray. Big fella evens it up. Then in transition, here's Heron ahead to Matt Bangle. Easy lay-in. Lakers up a pair more from Bangle. Pull-up jumper is pure. He had 20 to lead everybody. Lakers up 1, but sharing is fun, too. Bangle to Alex McClinsky in the corner for the triple. He had 11. Mercyhurst Prep a winner, 55-36. Matt Jones leading Erie First Christian Academy East. Get it? To face the Iroquois Braves under first-year head coach Rob Miola. First quarter, Andrew Montefiore inside the Euros. Chicha for 2. Then Steve Smith whips it real good. Chicha down low. Led everybody with 20. More from the Eagles. This time on defense. Smith the steal. Run to the floor. He finds Elder Pizarric down low for 2 of his 12. More pressure on D. Pizarric with the steal. He's going to launch it ahead to AC. Aaron Collins up and using the left. Erie first led 22-5 after one, and the Eagles soar 64-24. Off to a 2-0 start under first-year head coach Becky Leandro. The Cambridge Springs boys stepping out of region play this evening.
Blue Devils hitting the road for Harbor Creek.
Coach Leandro, the only woman leading a District 10 program, possibly the only one in the state. Ryan Smocks, Huskies trailing 42-38, final seconds of regulation. Ryan Whitman to Casey Smith in the corner for the tie, and we're going to overtime to the extra session. Huskies come out swinging. Greg Barney, first 4 points of OT for GB. He had 15, but back come the Devils. Jake Ferris, bucket here. He was big at the line as well. Cambridge up 50-48. Harbor Creek needs a 2 to tie, a 3 to win. Whitman bringing it up, beats the press, gives it all he's got off the rim. No good. Cambridge Springs improves to 3-0 under Becky Leandro. Your final in overtime, 50-48.
Absolutely, our defense came through in the end there. We needed some clutch plays at the end, defensive end, and we made our foul shots.
Yes, they did. Back to the Lewis Fitness and Performance scoreboard. Thanks, Jeff and company. Lance Welker and Jared Taylor combining for 31. Blue Devils get the victory. Cambridge Springs, as mentioned six times, is 3-0. Let's go to Northeast. Great Pickers taking on Corey. Second quarter, Beavers up 21-4. Northeast making a run behind Garrett Hine. Three ball is good. Corey can shoot it from deep as well. 6-3 center Taylor Willis connects. Later in the second, Beavers beat the trap. Get it? And it's Braden Elchinski from deep. He had 17. Final seconds of the first half. It's Willis with a miss. What you talking about? Micah Knapp says, I got this. Turn around. Don't drown. Off the glass and down. As time expires, Corey wins 55-30.
Over to Union City, where the Bears welcomed unbeaten Titty Ute Charter and some non-region action and a big lead for UC in the fourth. Union City freshman, don't blink, as Cole DeSimone knocks down the three ball from the corner, 52-11. Trouble in the corner for the visitors, but here's a nice looking three ball from the wing for Titty Ute Charter, trying to cut into that lead. Then off the Union City miss, here it comes. The finish on the inside. Ian Wenzikowski for two more, and he gets a couple more here in transition off the break. Maybe an intentional behind-the-back pass. I'm not sure about that one. Union City, though, I am sure. They win big, 61-14. They're at Northwestern tomorrow night in Albion.
Four boys basketball scores. Titusville beats Cochranson despite 35 from Cole Bernarding. Sharon over Cash, 69-52. Oil City over Rocky Grove, 52-29. Franklin blasts the Rockets of Slippery Rock, 71-44. Matt DeRisco's Sharpsville Blue Devils over Greenville, 67-52. Lakeview takes down Commodore Perry, 52-30. Still to come. We'll hit the ice.
The Otters' road trip moves from Windsor to Sarnia. We'll show you how it played out on Friday Night Lights.